Now we have a great opportunity to hear from a wonderful actor, Amber Heard, who has been in major Hollywood pictures, including Aquaman, among others. She's also an outspoken advocate for victims of domestic and sexual violence. Her advocacy is informed by her own experiences with image abuse. 5 years ago, Amber had private images of herself stolen off her phone by hackers and posted online.
Thank you so much. Thank you, Congresswoman Speier. And also, I want to thank you so much for being here, Congresswoman Katko, and everyone else. It's such an honor to be among you, this bipartisan group of congressional and community leaders. Thank you so much for your leadership on this very important issue. And thank you to David White, who brings the full force of the creative community here to this effort. I also want to thank two women who I want to say I deeply respect and deeply appreciate that are here with us, Holly Jacobs and Marianne Franks. I have worked closely with these two extraordinary women who have created and run the Cyber Civil Rights Initiative. I am proud to be here with them and serve as a CCRI ambassador. Holly and Marianne, your collective drive and resilience have helped so many, myself included. And your organization continues to help thousands of people around the world. CCRI is spearheading crucial efforts for the technological, social, and legal changes needed to successfully fight non-consensual pornography, online abuse, and the pervasive assault on privacy rights that is so rampant in our digital world. And I encourage the public and members of the media to please go and check out CCRI's website for more information and facts on this very important issue. All of these individuals standing in front of you today are leaders in so many different areas. And it's heartening to see your collective talents, energy, and resolve come together to tackle this very serious problem of non-consensual pornography. I can tell you firsthand that the acts of non-consensual pornography are humiliating, degrading, and life-altering. Non-consensual pornography is one of the worst violations of privacy, and it does not discriminate. Instead, it disproportionately affects women around the world with devastating personal and professional consequences. The online and offline worlds are inextricably linked. The notion that they are isolated from one another or somehow separate is false. An action in the digital world can and does have real ramifications in the real world. Once private, intimate content is released to the internet, it is virtually impossible to remove it from online spaces, further subjecting victims to harassment and judgment from strangers and acquaintances alike. It can result, and often does, in devastating economic, social, psychological, and even physical consequences. I experienced many of these consequences myself in 2014 when I was hacked and over 50 of my private images were stolen, manipulated, and released to the public online. My stolen, manipulated photos are still online to this day, posted again and again with sexually explicit and humiliating and degrading headlines about my body, about myself. I continue to be harassed, stalked, and humiliated by the theft of those images and those who use them. These images expose me far beyond the limits of my skin, the skin that covers my body. And it's used to continuously degrade, humiliate, and dehumanize me. The consequences to my personal safety, dignity, and livelihood are severe. My relationships, my and moreover, my expectation for bodily autonomy and liberty are forever compromised. And honestly, sadly, my mom and dad, my future children, are the ones that will always bear the brunt of the responsibility and the consequences of these actions. Okay, I know some may be thinking, okay, she's a Hollywood actress. That might be sad, but she must be used to a certain level of being exposed in the public. And while that's true, that I do and am represented on the internet in various motion pictures as characters, I can tell you right now, standing in front of you as a human being, that having this part, this kind of exposure of your life goes far beyond any character you could play or any scandal you could be attached to. This is your life, and it can't be ever undone. I am a high-profile, relatively privileged white woman in the entertainment industry. I am fortunate to have fantastic legal counsel and access to receptive law enforcement agents. However, even with all of these resources, the non-consensual pornography that impacts me is still out there and continues to this day. My harassers go unpunished. Believe me, if it can happen to me, it can happen to anyone. And it does. The privacy rights of lower income, LGBTQ, women of color, are at far, far greater risk. That's why we, as individuals with platforms and power, we have a particular responsibility, a duty, to fight to end non-consensual pornography. As Holly and Marianne will share with you, many of the victims affected by these horrible acts are teenage girls, teenagers, and young women. They are your daughters, your sisters, your grandchildren. These acts hurt and destroy our lives, their lives. One study on this issue, as Congresswoman Speier mentioned, has shown that half that are victims of non-consensual pornography have been harassed online as a result. 30% in real life. Further, and more devastating, nearly half have suicidal thoughts after non-consensual pornography impacts their life. That is why it is vitally important for members of Congress to support this legislation and make it a crime to distribute non-consensual pornography. There is no reason not to. And by codifying the right to privacy in matters of intimate, sexually explicit content, our commitment to ending the violence that is non-consensual pornography will not be tied to fleeting cycles of outrage or viral social media movements, but instead be enshrined in our most important legislative institution. Thank you so much for your time.
Passionate plea to us is one that we will certainly carry with us as we